music producers. I got posed a very great question on Curspiration. Take two. Music producers, I got posed a very interesting question on CurtisKingBeats.com/Curspiration. The question basically posed was, should music producers go to audio engineering school or should we just learn on our own? Great question. Let's talk about it. Music producers, there was a Soleil, I believe that's how I say your name, I'm sorry if I butcher it, but the question was, as producers, is it a good idea to go to school for audio engineering, or should we just be learning ourselves? Great question, because I was posed with the same question when I had to explain to my parents, what are you getting ready to do with your life after graduating from high school? When I looked up, I looked around and I was like, you know, I just really hope this music thing pays off. I don't really have a plan per se. I think what I wanted to do was work full time at a job. And, you know, college wasn't really in my mindset because I was like, there's no classes on FL Studio. So why am I here? Very, you know, a naive way of thinking. But initially, I looked around and I said, okay, well, what schools would actually keep my interest as a music producer slash rapper? What schools could, you know, possibly make what my career choice is look even more official, more so for my parents? Because I knew that if they thought that I was enrolled inside of a traditional school or a school that was credited for, you know, having graduates that went on to be very successful within the music business, it would justify, one, them helping me out with my tuition, or two, me just not wasting my time. So I looked at a few schools. If you don't know what an audio engineering school is, it's basically, you know, almost like a traditional college, except that it's literally one, it's almost like a trade school. There's one center line of focus. And in this particular case, you know, there's an MI Institute that I've heard of. There's a Full Sail University. I think that's really on the East Coast. I used to see it in my XXL magazines and be like, I wonder what that's all about. So I actually looked into it. You know, I, like I said, I wanted to make sure that my parent, you know, my mother and my father, who were split away from each other, but I wanted to make sure that they were both happy. I wanted to make sure that I was doing something that helped them to understand that I take this music thing that I was doing serious. And so we actually went on a tour of not MI, it was another music audio engineering institute we went to. And I looked around and, you know, everything looked great. I mean, the schooling, I was like, I could learn so much here. I could learn how to use the SSL board. I could learn how to, you know, better mix my stuff. Cause at that point in time, the only information that I had or got was off of YouTube. So it seemed like it was a lot of benefits. And then a few things came up. The first thing was the tuition. The tuition fee was ridiculous. And at that point in time, I didn't really have a whole lot of money in the pockets. My parents didn't really have a whole lot of money to put towards my college, but they're willing to put something significant if I needed it. And yeah, that tuition fee was crazy. You know, I think the entry fee was you needed to buy a laptop, a specific laptop they told you to buy in order to even become a student at this particular institute. And, you know, it was really, it was a little bit of a distance away. It's about 45 minutes to an hour without traffic from where I stayed at. And for a minute, it sounded like the thing to do. But then that tuition fee came up, and then something else that really bothered me came up. And it really bothered my pops, too, when he went to go on a tour with me, is that, you know, they did not guarantee you getting a job, you know? And I mean, I know that's kind of any degree can't guarantee you a job or a position, but at least you know when you walk out of there, you at least can get an introduction to being somewhere. You always have an opportunity because you have that paper that says, look, you've done your time. I hate to say done your time like you went to jail, but you went to school, you put your years in it. It shows that you can be dedicated to something. It shows that you're diligent and that you follow directions. It's just a lot of things that it stands for that an audio engineering degree, I didn't necessarily feel like therapy was going to do for me. Now, that was my particular, you know, point of view. I had a friend, my homie David May, who I probably suggested a lot of you guys go and get mixing and mastering from anytime you guys have asked me about that. But he went to MI Institute. And I tell you, you know, when he went there, he didn't know a lick about engineering. He came out. He knew how to do things like voiceovers on cartoons, and he knew how to, you know, I did a documentary one time, you know, Kings and Queens is the name of the documentary. It's on YouTube, but he did the audio engineering for that. And because he was involved in his music institute, he had the knowledge to do certain things like that. And also it made him a better music engineer. Now, could he have done that on his own? I mean, that's up to him to say, but when I look at my particular journey, I look at it and I say, there was a lot of things that I sort of was able to, you know, my learning curve is a bit faster because of the people that I came in contact with. There's certain things that were relevant to me that may not be relevant world, I shouldn't say the worldwide, but they're not relevant industry-wide, but me knowing these things literally gave me an advantage over the next producer or the next quote unquote producer slash engineer. That's another thing too. You know, a lot of producers have a passion for making beats. You have a passion for creating music. You have a passion for putting songs together, but you don't have a passion for mixing and mastering. And that's not to say you shouldn't learn it, but if it looks like in your career, somebody's going to be doing the mixing and mastering in place of you doing that, you know, you may not necessarily need to learn audio engineering in that case. And if you do need to learn any audio engineering, especially in 2017, there's way too many resources out there to not at least look into them. You know, from the BusyWorks Beats to I think even Superstar. Oh, I believe he has a course. But a lot of these dudes out here that do the same, you know, type of videos that this whole community contributes to producers, you know, there's a lot of information out there for you not to at least look into it. And, you know, it's really about what it is that you want to do. Now, the reason why I even thought about school was because of my parents, straight up. For some of you, you may be thinking about school, thinking like, well, maybe this is the way that I can elevate myself in the industry. This is the way I get my name out. I'm telling you right now, you can do that by yourself. You can do that literally by learning the things that you're learning on YouTube right now. You can do that by picking up, you know, some hours in a studio and ghosting somebody else, you know, learning underneath their particular wing. There's things that you can do to, you know, speed that learning curve up. But really what it's going to come down to is your ability to follow directions. It's going to become your ability to network. It's become your ability to, you know, literally model the people that you see that are successful, understand why they do certain things. And I'm telling you right now, if you're able to follow those particular criteria, you're going to be able to do that without having to pay that crazy tuition fee of going to an audio engineering school. I'm not here to discourage you from doing that. By all means, if you can afford to do it, jump in there and do that. I know, especially when it comes to EDM DJs, there's a particular school or sort of like almost like an audio engineering school that a lot of these EDM DJs go to when they first start off. Because they've gone through this school, it literally gives them, it's almost like being part of a fraternity. They're part of this network now where they said, oh, you went through that school? Cool. Come on in. You know, they have gigs that are ready up and aligned for them. They have studio sessions because people are coming in on a regular basis speaking at these institutes that are a direct connect to them now. You know, things could have changed. When Curtis was trying to do this, this was, oh my God, what was this like? 13 years ago when I was trying to go to trade school or trying to go to audio engineering school. Things have got to change. I hope they change, especially for those who are going to these audio engineering schools. Perhaps even the amount of money, the fee has changed as well. But that's my particular point of view on it. Do you need it? You don't absolutely need it. Can it be beneficial? Absolutely. But really, it's up to you to go there and ask the questions, ask the things that you really want to know. You know, if it's valuable for you to know if you can get a job after this, hammer that away and see the way that they react to that question. If it's important for you to learn the craft of engineering, I mean, you're in a great environment to do that, and it's specific for what you're there for. It's not like they're saying, yo, I want to be an audio engineer, but I kind of want to rap, and they're going to just throw you in a room with other rappers and other producers. That's not what it is. It's a specialty school. It's like a trade school. So with that in mind, you must determine for your situation why you're doing it and make sure that the why that you're determining it for is not what my why was. My why was literally just so I can make mama and pops happy. But all in all, that's not going, that would have not been, I don't think that would have turned out into a positive outcome because I wasn't there for, you know, my passion. And my passion was to be able to be this DIY producer, rapper, and learn the craft hands-on and learn it the way that I was learning it. That's what I was passionate about. It was a trial and error, you know. So that being said, I would just say make the determination for yourself, Soleil. You'll know when your gut instinct starts talking to you. Once again, it's another Curspiration Doodle. If you need some more of this juice, please subscribe to the channel below. Be a part of the notification gang. Hey, thank you to everybody that is a part of the Curtis King community. If you want to be a part of the Curtis King community, the very one percentile of producineurs and rappineurs that are here seeking answers and sharing answers and information, go to curtiskingbeats.com/membership and join today. But going back to the topic at hand, any producers who have gone to audio engineering school, please update your peers because Curtis King is obviously 13 years outdated when it comes to this particular topic. But I think it's a great topic to address. Share your information, share your experience, let them know what it's all about. Tell them the good, tell them the ugly too, because we gotta be honest with each other. And in this life, you will not be full of life until you decide to live life to its fullest. Curtis King of CurtisKingBeats.com. When I listen to you, it's a liability. Cause you be mentally killing my inner energy. So I'm concealing my feelings before you injure me.